Action. Okay. Camera start. We will be taking an example of hexagonal plane. An hexagonal plane of 30 sides has its surface parallel to VP with a distance of 20 mm. Parallel to VP with a distance of 20 mm means 20 mm in front. Draw its projections when a side of the hexagonal plane is parallel to HP and perpendicular to HP. How you can justify your plane is parallel to HP, one of the side is parallel to HP and perpendicular to HP? Two conditions for that. Next, incline at 45 degrees to the HP. First is, one of the edge is parallel to HP. You have to have three conditions here. A, first is your one of the edge, this is the edge, these are the edges. What is the corner?
Vertex.
What is the corner definition?
Vertex.
Joining of two or more edges is a corner. If it is a solid, then you have to join three edges. If it is a plane, you have to join two edges to form a corner. Right? In the question, it is given that your plane is 30 mm side and it is parallel to VP. So top view would be a line, right? Compulsory line. Now that line is going to be changed in dimension for each and every condition. Our first condition A is parallel to HP. One of the edge is parallel to HP. This is HP and this edge, wherever it is located, it is parallel. It is not changing its orientation. This edge, down one, edge is parallel to HP. So where, what you can draw? In this position, you can draw your front view. In this position, you can draw your front view. Next, that edge is perpendicular to HP. Like this, in standing position. In standing position, this is the standing position of this. Your edges are perpendicular to your HP. This is the HP. And that edge, this edge, is perpendicular to your HP. Next, that edge is 45 degrees inclined to HP. Means this edge is 45 degrees inclined to HP. Even though our polygon is parallel to VP only and plane surface is perpendicular to HP only. Simple thing is orientation of your plane. It is like this or angled. Okay, we have three conditions for drawing this. First condition, we have to keep our edge parallel to HP, draw the front view, top view. Next, our edge in this standing position. Standing position, your edge is perpendicular to HP. So you have to draw the front view and you have to draw the top view. Next, our edge is inclined to HP, like this. So in the previous condition, we have discussed about triangle. So, I have a triangle also here. Sitting position, standing position, reverse position. Sitting, sitting position, standing position, reverse position, inclined. So here also we can consider this as, you can see the black edges of this one. Standing, sitting position, standing position, inclined position. That's all. This sitting position, standing position, inclined position. That is the orientation of the surface. That's not inclined. This is the orientation of your position in existence of plane. Okay. So according to the given, what is the given question? Data. So given data, it is a hexagonal plane, side 30, parallel to VP, and perpendicular to HP. Right? Next, A, one edge parallel to HP. If one edge, suppose I am taking this edge, is parallel to HP, then obviously this edge is also parallel to HP, right? B, one edge perpendicular to HP. Means like this position, perpendicular to HP. Next, one edge is inclined to HP by 45 degrees. So I'll take this edge 45 and I'll draw the figure. Those, this would be your conditions: sitting, standing, inclined. So for this, XY line, first A, one edge is parallel to HP. Parallel to HP, our edge. From this, can I draw a hexagon? How to draw the hexagon? Fix your drafter to 30 degrees one side and another 60 degrees, right? Finish. Our hexagon name A, B, C, D, E, F. So front view, you can see the horn A dash, B, C, D, E, F. And this is the side 40, because it is a 30, right, 30, because it is a regular. No need of mentioning this side for every edges, one side is 30. Next, project this down. And in question, it is given that it is parallel to VP and 20 mm in front. Means from looking from top, you can see the figure 20 mm below XY. So I am taking 20 below line. What is this point? Yep. This point, by E and A, looking from top, you can see E first, then A. So, E, A, this point. Next, D and B, D and B. Next, C, it is individual. So, A, B, C, D, E, F. A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay? A, B, C, D, E, F. In this manner. Next, parallel condition, finish. Now what is this? A. Next, coming for standing position. I take perpendicular line. In that, I'll be placing first side. Again, same angle method. Hexagon. The side is how much? 30. A, B, C, D, E, F. Without dash? With dash. With dash. Because it's a front view. From front we can see the horns, right? Next. Projectors 20 mm Now, what I have to look at here? Looking in this direction, first we can see F. F, A, E, B, D, C. This is your top view. This is your front view. And true shape. True shape. True shape, front view. And this is top view. Next, C. What is given in C? That edge is inclined at 45 degrees to the HP. Means, this is HP and your figure is inclined at HP. Means, suppose this is that edge. That edge is making 45 degrees. Figure is same, but your orientation of the plane is different. Standing position, sitting position, inclined position. So, I draw an array. Here also array. Why don't we draw an array here? Because x, y is the reference for that. So this is 45 degrees. On this, can we draw the plane? A, B, C, D, E, here. Then project us down. And 20 mm in front of BB. Now F dash. Here, E dash, E, B dash, D, A dash, A, B dash, B, C dash, C. This is your front view and true shape. And this is top. Finished. And you have to give the dimensions also here. Yes, finish.